Shabbat shalom, everybody. Today we live in a day and age where many people believe that, you know, if you do what feels right, then that's what's right in your heart. And many people follow after their own hearts and do what's right within their own eyes. And they, in and of themselves, make themselves out to be Epicurean philosophers. You can read about them in Acts 17, verse 18. But the Epicurean philosophers taught was from their teacher Epicurus, who was a Greek who believed that the highest form of attainment that one can get was personal desire. Whatever it may be, fulfill it. And that was the highest point and the meaning of life. What my brother Pepper is going to do today is expose the flaws in that philosophy, if you will. And it is my hope that you will walk away learning something today that you didn't know prior.
Brother Paul states in 1 Timothy 5:23, stop drinking only water and use a little wine instead because of your stomach and your frequent ailments. Now, people take this verse right here and use that as an excuse to go out and go to a rave. People take this verse and use it as an excuse to drink in excess, to sit there and become alcoholics in the faith, and then want to say they're in the faith. Now, I can't say, coming from scripture, that there's anything wrong with drinking. But what I can say is, when it comes to this, must be done in moderation. Now, I personally don't drink. I gave all that up. When the set-apart spirit takes a hold of you, certain things you're just going to give up. Then we find in Proverbs 31, verse 4, it says, it is not for kings to drink wine, nor princes strong drink. Some of you run around here looking like, well, where the kings at? Well, we find in Revelations 5:10 that we will be a nation of kings and priests. I don't drink. And if we're going to be a nation of kings and priests, and we read what we read in Proverbs 31:4, then how much more a queen? How much more a princess? 1 Peter 5:8 says, be sober, be vigilant, because your adversary, the devil, walketh about like a roaring lion, seeking whom he may devour. And Matthew 5:14 tells us we are the light of the world, and the city built on the hill cannot be hid. But even still, we the light of the world, so how are we going to run around like the world? I know I'm rough around the edges. There's certain things that I got to tighten up on, as certain things everybody got to tighten up on. But drugs is something that I don't deal with no more. Ever since the Holy Spirit, or the set-apart spirit, I received the Ruach, I knew that was just going to hinder me. And I can't defend people out here smoking weed. And I can't defend people out here drinking to an excess like people are doing and using scripture to justify what they're doing. If that's something that you want to do, then that's what you do. But leave scripture out of it. Stop trying to twist and contort scriptures, especially when it comes to smoking weed, to make it fit your own personal beliefs. Nowhere in scripture does it justify anybody doing drugs of any kind. And when it comes to weed, people like to argue that it's a herb. People like to go to Genesis and point out the fact where it says that all the plants of the field are given to us for meat. So it can't be nothing wrong with weed. But no matter which way you chop it up, you can't escape the fact that marijuana is a drug, period. Because there's certain things you got to do to it. It's cultivated for that very purpose of inebriation. Then scripture says it was given to us for meat. Meat in scripture is pertaining to something that you eat, something you devour. Now it's for the cancer patients, and I know people got their ailments going on. You know, they make oil out of it, ingest it, but they don't smoke it. And I don't care what nobody say, smoking anything causes your body harm. It does your body damage. It says in 1 Corinthians 6:19, do you not know that your bodies are temples of the set-apart spirit that you have received from the Most High, and you are not your own? So what make you think the set-apart spirit want to cohabitate with smoke? Even Aaron's sons, Nadab and Abihu, got smoke for offering up strange fire in Leviticus 10:1. Now all we got running around us right now in this day and age is a bunch of people getting high on drugs, gateway drugs, now they on pills, and that done led them into doing methamphetamines and all other types of various drugs and things that hinder their health and cause them to have more physical ailments, and they're just damaging their bodies. Their bodies are decaying slowly. You got people in the faith that believe that smoking weed actually connects them to the Most High. We told what connects us to the Most High is the Messiah, not a drug. And certain people feel like they need this drug. They have developed their dependence on this drug. And I don't care how much weed you smoke and how many problems you got. At the end of the day, when the blunt gone and you done came down off your high, you still left with the same problems that were there before you got high. No matter how much you forgot about them while you were high. So it's just like that turkey that stank downstairs and you couldn't find out where that bad smell was coming from. So you got you a can of ouse and started spraying. Everything was okay for the first 15 minutes. But then after that 15 minutes was up, that smell came right back. And what you had to do? You had to spray again. We told the Messiah for this very purpose is our cure. Rest in him. Find solace in him. Not no drug. Dependency on a drug. When I have HaMashiach, and my body is a temple of the set-apart spirit that I received from the Most High. Now I'm fine. I want to read you something real quick. The Greek word for practice of spiritism is pharmakia, which literally means druggery. Now this term came to be connected with spiritism because in ancient times, drugs were used when invoking the powers of demons. People open themselves up. People use drugs to open themselves up and make themselves more susceptible to seducing spirits. It's just like with the oracles. They would take drugs and they would prophesy. Things that came from their own minds. Visions that came from their own hearts. And people are doing this today, and these people think they are receiving messages from the Most High. These people really believe that they are, these people really believe that they are prophets, apostles, people who are sent forth with messages. And you sitting here and you're getting high and you're doing all types of things to your body. It's time we repent of doing these things. We don't need these things. If we have the Ruach, we don't need these things. And furthermore, you can't tell me, coming from someone who used to sell drugs, you can't tell me that you are a light to the person you buying drugs from. Matthew 5:14 say we are a light to the world. How are we going to talk to anybody about the gospel or preach repentance or even knowledge itself? When we sitting up here and we buying bags from them. If I'm sitting there serving somebody and they want to talk to me about something biblical, I'm like, man, my head, man, I just served you a quarter ounce. I don't want to hear nothing you got to say. Because all you are after that point is a walking dollar sign. Nothing more. You lose your potency. We are the salt of the earth. You lose your potency. Psalms 1:1 says, blessed is the man that walketh not in the counsel of the unrighteous, nor stands in the way of sinners. You sitting here running with these people. You're getting high with these people. Then you want to turn around and preach the word. Are you serious? It's certain things we got to stop doing. Inebriation, free your mind. And one more thing, I know it's getting late, but people love to say, the world would be a much better place if we could all walk around high. Well, newsflash, we are all walking around high. We got pharmaceuticals in the water and antidepressants found in our drinking water. And the fluoride levels in the water, it's already a known fact that fluoride keeps one docile. Then on top of that, it lowers IQ. So we as the body of Messiah, as believers, shouldn't want to put anything else in our bodies, no type of drug or anything of the sort that will further compromise our structural integrity. They already got stuff in the Air Force. They already got this whole agenda going on that's designed to keep us stupid and dumbed down. Now, if you look around you, we have become nothing more than a nation of sheep that are asleep. So right now, we headed for perilous times, and we're going to need all the sobriety we can get. Your drinking buddies could care less about precepts. The people you run around smoking with and getting high with could care less about the word that's in you. If you got it in you, they can care less about the rock. Be sober and be vigilant. My name is not important.